with us a very eminent personality, Mr. Subir Senji from Calcutta. He is the president of the SSB Jewelers Association and also the director of BCCN Jewelers Calcutta. It is a very old jewelry firm. How are you, Subir Senji?
Well, I'm fine.
All right, great.
I'm going with the tide, fighting with the tide.
Right, great. So, as you know, GJPC has organized their second edition of IHS Virtual. They had their first edition a few months back. Because of the current circumstances, still the travel is not very convenient for everyone. It is not safe. So the virtual mode is the ideal mode for, you know, purchasing and sourcing, and IHS has been using this modem. So we would like to know your views and how you have been a manufacturer, you have been a retailer, you have been part of IHS for many years. So please share your views on this virtual platform.
Well, I have been, and our company has been connected with IHS for a very long time.
Right.
I think we started IHS exhibitions, being a participant and an exhibitor.
Right.
Way back in 1989 or 90.
Okay.
And we had been regularly participating in this show, as well as having a stall and displaying our jewelry for probably 20, 22 years. So we have a very long relationship with IHS.
Right.
And the Gem and Jewelry Council, right, who have been out organizing this lovely show. Now, with the pandemic, it is not possible to have the reality show at the exhibition hall. So, rightly, council has decided on coming on to the virtual platform. It is beneficial for the wholesalers and manufacturers to display their products, and as well as beneficial for the retailers to procure the jewelry as per their requirements. So now, presently, this is the ideal platform for displaying and purchasing of jewelry, which rightly council has selected. The first show was there. Probably there were some shortcomings, I don't know, because I didn't participate in that. But in a refined form, the second show is about to happen in January. And I would request all retailers to take advantage of this opportunity, get them registered, and procure jewelry as per their requirements. We had a good business opportunity during Dhanteras and Diwali.
Right.
Luckily, there was a good demand of jewelry, and this has been continuing throughout this marriage season.
Right.
So definitely, people would like to reimburse their stocks with new designs, new concepts. So this is an opportunity to make this happen.
Right. That's great. I think good comprehensive view you have given about this virtual show. And what we understand is that this time IHS has got a lot of new features added to it, a lot of new, enhancements they have done, so which will be more user-friendly. And coming to the overall business scenario, Subir Senji, Eastern region, Calcutta is known as a jewelry hub. So how is the jewelry business potential there going on? And what do you see the new year 2021 for the jewelry industry?
I feel that it is having a bright future because of the COVID situation. Like, markets were closed for 2 months.
Right.
From June, gradually things came in, and probably it was quite slow till September. From October, with the support of the gold price increase, definitely consumers have regained their confidence to buy jewelry and invest in gold.
Right.
We have seen for the last 3 months, there has been a constant escalation of gold prices. And definitely, with other markets becoming sluggish, gold will be the only winner. So we hope that 2021 should be a very good year to come back and recover whatever damage was done in 2020.
Right. So on this optimistic note, we really thank you for your valuable inputs and your valuable comments and your suggestions and encouragement for the IHS virtual show. Thank you.